here again with another wonderful young lady that is actually in the Happy documentary, and she is powerful. I did some research on you, and this sister, Essence Magazine, Black Enterprise Magazine, she is just wonderful. This documentary, why was it important for you to be part of it?
You know, when it comes to the whole Happy movement, what I love most about it was solution-based. You know, we can sit and talk about the issues, and we do, to a black and blue in the face, but, you know, it doesn't move us forward. You know, we know what the issues are. But what I love most about the documentary is that it focused on why those issues are, you know, the way that they are, and what we can do to move forward. And I think that having that conversation is so important.
Powerful, powerful. I watched your TEDx. Interview and powerful. Now, when it comes to the Happy movement, and we're fortunate to have someone, because a lot of people think the old people doing this, but you are, I wouldn't say young, but you are nice age, and you're collecting the numbers and the gaps when it comes to personal finance. What would you like people to walk away with after they watch it?
I think one thing that is really, really powerful is just the history aspect of it. I love that so much, just seeing, you know, where we came from, going all the way back to the motherland, and, you know, the economics back then, and seeing the similarities. And I think that is really, really important. And then also, I know I'm a little biased, but I think we should all take away the cooperative economics part of it, and, you know, that being one of the solutions for increasing the local economy and black communities. So, you know, going out and banking black and supporting black-owned businesses, I would hope that people, you know, take that away and use those action items in the future.
Got it. Tell us who Mandy Bowman is. You have an app that is powerful. So tell us about this app that we want to promote.
Yes. So the app is called Official Black Wall Street. Didn't actually start as a business. I'm a full-time entrepreneur now. It started as just a resource. I learned about Black Wall Street in Tulsa, Oklahoma, and this, you know, amazingly self-sufficient neighborhood. And it really inspired me, you know, being from Brooklyn, New York, and seeing how gentrification had changed my neighborhood, it really inspired me to go out and support as many black-owned businesses as possible. And so it went from just being a spreadsheet to being a website and a couple of social pages, and then it became an app with, you know, tons of supporters. We have over 5,000 businesses listed at this point, and it spans 11 different countries around the world, from mostly in the U.S., but also in South Africa, the Netherlands, Japan, Jamaica, and a couple of other countries.
So this can be the new version of the Green Book.
Yes, it
can.
Wow, absolutely.
An internet version of the Green Book.
Mm-hmm.
Very powerful,
yes.
Very powerful.
Thank you.
So how can we contact and get the information to be on the app?
You can go to our website, officialblackwallstreet.com. There's an orange join button right there, so it'll walk you through everything, or you can shoot us an email at info@officialblackwallstreet.com.
Wow, powerful. If you are thinking about having us premiere the documentary anywhere in the universe that you are, contact us below and we will be there front and center. It's an excellent documentary. I have a question. The elders say that people in your age group are not financially savvy. Can you explain that and clear that up for us? Because I look at you and I'm like, well, no, that's not true, but can you clear that up for us?
I would say that we are pretty financially savvy. I think that we're the generation of, you know, the internet, and so it's a lot easier for us to find resources and share them. And so I think there are so many different resource groups of, you know, black millennials where we're literally sharing this information and sharing accounting information and,
wow,
you know, all these other things. And it's amazing. Like, I just met with a sister. She owns a business. She's an accountant as well. And she was walking me through all these things about, you know, this is your business, but this is more beneficial for you when it comes to finances and when it comes to taxes. So we want to do this in the near future.
Right.
And just being able to share those resources, I think that's amazing. I feel like our generation is doing an amazing job at just, you know, creating multiple streams of income, sharing those resources with other people. I've seen so many webinars of, you know, Black entrepreneurs saying, this is the blueprint, this is how I did it, this is how you can do it. So I think when it comes to sharing and, you know, sharing those resources, I think we are, you know, financially savvy. You know, we're getting there.
Good. I'm impressed. So what's your shirt?
Oh, it says Black Entrepreneurs Matter.
Okay, good. Yes. Tell us the importance of having a business plan when it comes to Black entrepreneurs.
Extremely important. Your business plan is your roadmap. It wow. helps you understand, you know, what your next steps will be, where you see yourself and maybe, or where you see your business in maybe a year or two, and how you can, you know, how you can get there and make sure that you're constantly on the right track. So even with us, I reference my business plan maybe at least once a month, just to make sure that I'm on the
right
track.
Path, right.
Yes, uh-huh. Absolutely. So I think it's extremely important just to make sure that you have that framework and that groundwork, so you know where you're going and what your goals are. I'm such a stickler for, you know, making sure that people don't speak any doubts on your dreams and your ambitions. And so I make sure that I surround myself with people who understand how serious I am about those things, and they're constantly supporting and, you know, giving positive energy to that.
Well, I believe in you.
Thank you.
I'm joining the app today.
Yes, please.
So if you haven't joined the app, make sure you join the app today. Like, why are you doing what you're doing?
It's my passion. You know, I've had so many jobs that were cool jobs, but this was the one that made me, you know, want to get up in the morning and do work. And it made, you know, the sleepless nights didn't really matter as much to me, because I knew I was doing something that would benefit my community. And in the beginning, I mean, I read so many stats about Black entrepreneurs and, you know, the different hurdles that we face, from, you know, the how difficult it is for us to get bank loans. And even when we do get those bank loans, the interest rate is, you know, enormous compared to our white counterparts.
Right.
There was even a story recently, I think this was on NPR, but it was about this this Black-owned business in St. Louis. And they had a credit score, I think, of about 755. They had annual profits of over $200,000 a year consistently, and they still could not get a bank loan. And so seeing those stats and seeing, you know, all the different hurdles that we have to go through, again, with gentrification,
right,
and the different Black-owned businesses, even in New York City, that closed down year after year. I know I'm throwing a lot of stats at you, but BuzzFeed also reported that over a five-year period, I think starting in 2012, 30% of the Black-owned businesses in New York City disappeared. They closed down. And so when you see all of those different stats, it makes me want to do something, especially as someone who's always wanted to be an entrepreneur. You know, that really rang home for me.
Make sure you stay in contact with us so that we let you know when these dates are going to be rolled out. And there are more cities and more countries coming that we are rolling this whole documentary out. So we want to thank you. And thank you. Thank you so much for coming out
thank
and sharing
you for
this
having
with
me.
Us. And we will be, listen, this is, you're going to be hearing from this woman soon. She's going to be a powerhouse.
Yes.
So thank you very much.